Hey, how do you know you made a good photograph? What is a good image? Today, in the studio. Hello everyone, my name is Alex Silva and this is Alex Silva Photography. Today, let's talk about what makes a good image. How do we know that we shot a good image? Let's rewind a bit. Every time we are in a shoot, every time we create images, well, we press the shutter many times, of course. However, at some point in the post-processing phase, we need to select our best images, the ones that we're going to work with and then deliver to the customer. But how do we select those images? I run into the same problem and I decided to do some research and then share it with you. While doing this research, I found out that there are so many criteria and so many ways to define a good image. So I came up, based on all the blog posts and the articles that I read and videos that I saw, and I came up with 5 questions that you can ask about your image to determine if it should be used to be delivered. Let's get to it. Question number 1. Is there a clear subject in your image? If your image shows without a doubt what is the main subject or your main subjects in your image without filling the frame with clutter, that is a good image. On the other hand, if your image is full of clutter and you cannot see what's going on with the image, what is the main point of it, that image probably needs to be discarded. Question number 2. Is your subject in focus? And this is where some people actually struggle a bit. Of course, we can trust the autofocus system of our camera and things like that. However, we need to make sure that if we have a clear subject in our image, if it's very clear for the viewer what the main subject is in your photograph. But if it's out of focus, we're not so sure about what's going on here. On the other hand, if we can clearly see the details of your subject, well, let's keep going. That is a good candidate to be delivered. Let's go with question number 3. Does your image follow a composition rule? And here we can talk about composition all day long. And I've heard so many people talk about the rule of thirds. I think that is the most abused rule of composition. And there are many more that you can use. However, let's make sure that your image follows one composition rule. Some people say that rules are meant to be broken, but hey, composition rules were defined, not quite invented, but defined even before photography was invented. They have stayed current because they work. And let's follow them so our image has more impact. Question number 4. Does your image tell a story? This may be tricky because usually stories are divided in 3 acts. It's kind of difficult to express 3 different acts, introduction, conflict, and conclusion, in one image. However, it is possible. Depending on the requirements of your image for your customer, you may not need to tell a story, but still, if we tell stories, the viewer will get emotionally attached to your image, so it will be more effective. And finally, question number 5. Does the lighting and exposure help with the story and highlight the subject? It's a bit of a tricky question and kind of long, but if the image is too dark or too bright, or it has too much contrast, or it's not contrasty enough, Well, you may have a clear subject, but you may not be helping it stand out from the rest of the image, or your story may not be that clear. And so we need to make sure that whatever we expose, and however we make adjustments to the exposure, let's make sure that those adjustments help tell the story and help highlight our subject. If you can say yes to all five questions about your image, yeah, it is a very good image. On the other hand, if you can only say yes to four questions, it's still a very good image. However, if you only have three yeses, maybe it's time for us to discard that image, or maybe it's not the strongest candidate for you to deliver to your customer. Now, there you have it. These are five questions that you can use to select your images. Of course, this is more of a guideline and not the only criteria to be used. Of course, you may have other requirements, other more specific requirements from your client about your images. If that is the case, let's make sure that you follow those requirements first. As I mentioned before, these five questions provide you with a good starting point, and these are good criteria to select your work, but they are not the only ones. And I'm pretty sure you have some other guidelines that you'd use. If that is the case, I'm seriously curious about them, and I would love for you to share those guidelines in the comments section. I really hope you liked this video and found it informative and entertaining. If that is the case, please press the like button. And of course, you can subscribe to the channel. But more important, please remember to keep learning and keep shooting. See you in the next video. Thank you.